Hey my lovelies, welcome back to my channel. Welcome to any newbies. I really appreciate you being here. If you like my videos, please hit like, subscribe and comment down below. I love hearing from any one of you. I love reading your comments. So we're going to do a message from a loved one here. So it can be any loved one. It can be your partner. It can be someone you just met. Cousin, brother, sister. You get the gist. So let's get started. So spirit angels, ancestors, what message? I can't even remember what I was really saying. Anyway. The rival. They chose someone else over you and thought it wasn't what they wanted. They thought it was the right thing to do. Ugh. Do you know what? For weeks now, I don't know if it's the same energy that I'm picking up on or whether you guys are all going through the same thing. But what I'm picking up here is that there's a lot of cheating. Or it's mainly some, you know, your partners, ex-partners if you want to put it, have bogged off with someone else. So let's have a look. Let's get some more. So there's a rival there. Spirit. Love message, heartfelt message do you have for the collective? Yes, that's better. I phrased it right. Potential. They're deep in their thoughts about you, realizing their distractions prevented them from seeing the potential in you. Yeah. So they obviously got distracted by this rival here, which is obviously a karmic. Even this person you were involved with could have been a karmic. But they were blinded to you actually being the real deal here. I mean, I'd be very surprised if the Emperor or the Empress doesn't come out in the reading. So let's get some more. Okay. So we've got leap of faith. They did not expect this love to run this deep. They're putting their pride aside and taking the leap of faith. Separation. They're focusing on their own personal journey and choosing not to focus on love because there is nothing to give. And then on the back of the deck, we've got the losing battle here. You are fighting a losing battle against your opposition. Don't downgrade yourself. Play at your level, not theirs. So this is not a separation as in you're going to get back together and then you're going to separate. That's not what I'm seeing here. What I'm seeing is you are separated from this person. They chose someone else over you. Spirit wants you to know, don't downgrade if this person does decide to come back and ask for a second chance with you, because you will be downgrading, basically. Let me see if you're in the shot. Bloody ring light broke. Yep, you're in the shot. I think you are. So yeah, what was I saying? So it looks like that they're going to wake up because they're going to notice that you were the real deal here, and they settled for second class, second citizen, whatever you want to call it here. But I think if you were to go back with this person, you will be downgrading. So let's have a look. They've left you for somebody else. Let me get my breakup oracle here. I'm not using these. So tell us a bit more about this situation here, Spirit. Tell us a bit more about this situation. So we have shut down. I'm swearing off dating. Have no desire to be with anyone. Then we've got divorce. I'm ending my long-term relationship to be with you. Can't be trusted. Thank you, Spirit. Rebound. I just need someone to help me get over the pain of losing you. So this, I am picking up player energy here. I mean, for some of you, you could have been married to this person and you're going through a divorce at the moment. But I think it's you that's actually shut down, not them. this is you. You've shut down. You've gone off a dating. You know, you must have had enough. Spirit is saying that this person can't be trusted. And it could be where you end up rejecting this person. If that's what you end up doing, they're going to end up on a rebound. So, you know, still can't keep it in their pants or their knickers. I mean, this energy here, I'm not making a move. You know where to find me. But I don't know though. I'm picking up collective. It's you guys here that you've got this attitude of up yours, basically. So let's get some tarot cards. Tell us more about this situation. You know, this is meant to be a love message, or you know, any other message here. Well, so far they've basically said that they chose wrong. They didn't choose wisely. So give us a bit more, please, Spirit. Any more messages here? No, thank you. Okay. Yeah, it's over. Something, you've had clarity, and why are my cards upside down? I hate when my cards upside down. You had some kind of enlightenment, some kind of like wake up call when it comes to this connection here with this person. You've seen the light, basically, of what they're all about and who they're all about, and you know, you're loving yourself now. We've got death and we've got inspiration, which is the Ten of Wands. Now, when this relationship ended, because this is all about endings, death, when this relationship ended, it really did put a lot of pressure on your shoulders. Maybe you've got children with this person, you know, and you've had to carry all the load yourself. It could be that, you know, when you split up with someone, you're grieving. And this is what I'm seeing here, is that you're really, really grieving over losing this person. And now what they did to you is the baggage is now on your shoulders. You're carrying this baggage around with you constantly now. I'm hearing you guys say to yourselves, why me? Was there something wrong with me? Did I do something wrong? You know, it's nothing you did wrong. This is all about them. And like Spirit's saying to you here, if you were to go back with this person, you are downgrading. And I do believe that you are worth so much more than this person here. Oh. But it can't help who you love at the end of the day. But I mean, on the back of this deck as well, here we've got healing. I'm taking time to heal and accept the love I know and I deserve. This is you guys. You look at this Sun card as well. She's meditating. This is you guys. You're going to be healing. You're going to be all right. You won't be carrying this baggage around for that much longer. So tell us more here. So, didn't even get anything out. But anyway, the cards want to talk. Let them talk. So we have the Queen of Pentacles. And I am not taking reversals. Four of Pentacles. No, sorry. Oh, Four of Cups. These cards are really weird. I've never used them before. I've had them for a long time, but I thought, you know what? Let me see if I can, you know. I will get there. Just ignore me. So, yeah. You are the Queen of Pentacles. You are someone that is so humble. You know, you do well for yourself. It could be that you own your own business. You could have, you know, something going on social media. You know, it could have a platform. But you are financially secure. You do so well for yourself. And the Queen of Pentacles is someone that is, she is the most valuable card in the deck, basically. And this is why there's going to be a regret here on their part, because they didn't they didn't see your potential. It could be that you may have started a business or something. You may have started something up. This is what I'm picking up here. You may have started something just before they left, and they may have actually put you down about this. You know, oh, it's not going to go anywhere. It's not going to do anything. You know, this is for some of you. You know, take what resonates. But you're going to be doing so well financially. You're going to be blooming. And the lovely thing about you guys is, you don't rub it in anyone's faces. You're so humble about it. You know, you share your wealth. You're very generous with people that you love and you care for. So this is an earth sign. We're dealing with a Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn, if any of you guys are that in the chat. The thing is, though, you felt so rejected by this person. I feel like they rejected your ideas. They rejected your inspiration here when it comes to what you wanted to do with yourself. So yeah, I think you just got fed up with it as well. But you feel very rejected by what this person did to you. On the back of the deck we have the Ace of Voices. The Ace of Voices is the Ace of Swords. So what I'm saying is the truth, Spirit is saying. And also this is truth and clarity. And I think Spirit wants you to be true to yourself. And you need to start speaking your truth when it comes to this energy here that's come through. So let's see, what do they want to say to the collective, Spirit? What does this energy want to actually say to the collective? Because even though this energy's come through, it's like you guys have dominated your energy's dominated the reading, which is nothing wrong with that. Muse and materials. Do you know what? I don't even know what that card is. Oh, Two of Pentacles. Don't hate me. So we've got Seven of Inspiration, Seven of Wands, Page of Pentacles, and Knight of Inspiration, which is Wands. Yeah, okay, I'm seeing what's going on here. So I asked, what else does this person want to say? You know, what else, you know, what more can they say? So you've got the Two of Materials here, which is Pentacles. This is juggling. So this person is still juggling, and I feel like as well that when they come back, or they try and come back, they're still going to be juggling. This whoever they're involved with, they're not done. They're still on the scene. And the reason I'm saying that, guys, is because we've got the Knight of Wands here. The Knight of Wands is the player energy in the deck. The Knight of Wands is also the most immature card in the deck. They're not fully mature. Even if they're a grown-ass man or grown-ass woman, they're not mature. They think with their private parts more than their head. This is someone that will come in and give you all the, you know, they give you the sweet talk, you know, the charming, whatever you want to call it, and then they're off again. They've got no staying power, the Knight of Wands. They just can't keep it in their pants, basically. Or their knickers. Thongs. So yeah, so here is the Seven of Inspiration, which is the Seven of Wands. This is Spirit wants you to stand your ground, protect yourself. Don't let this person come in and mess up your whole what was it that came out earlier of the healing. You know, you had two cards of healing. Don't let them come into your life and undo everything that you've done on yourself. You've got the Page of Materials here, the Page of Pentacles. Page of Pentacles is someone that is coming up with a plan, someone that wants to bring you good news. Maybe they feel like they're gonna, maybe they feel like you will appreciate this good news, that they want you back. You know, that's the energy I'm picking up. We do have the Knight of Wands here. I mean, the Page of Pentacles is usually someone that is very loyal and dependable dependable, but no, they're not. You need to be loyal to yourself, guys, not the other way around. So what this energy is basically saying here is I'm coming back to mess you around once again. What's their next move, Spirit? What's their next move? Hang on, guys. What's their next move towards the collective, Spirit? What are their plans? What are their plans, Spirit? No, I don't think so. What are their plans? Quite thick, these cards. And I can't shuffle with my arms on the table because my ring light broke, so I'm having to use the other wobbly thing, and that thing rattles about if I lean on the table. So, oh my god. Right, let's get it together. So, what is their next move? What do they have planned? I'll shuffle all night if I have to. You will tell me what your plans are. Come on. There we go. Thank you. Three of Pentacles. So, we have the Six of Voices, which is the Six of Swords. Page of Cups, okay. Ten of Cups, oh, and the Fool in Reverse, oh, that's new, we've had the Fool in Reverse before, and the Three of Materials. Three of Materials is the Three of Pentacles. Three of Pentacles can be a third party, it can be celebrations, it can be, you know, birthdays, weddings, just overall gatherings, or like I said, a third party. Now, I've seen the third party come up twice, that there is someone still in the picture. But I've got a funny feeling that this person's going to try and bump into you at a party or something. Some of you guys have got this person on block. Maybe you've told them just to stay away from you. So I do feel like there's going to be a gathering or some sort, and they're going to actually make sure they're going to bump into you there. Now, they want to smooth things over with you. They want things to go back to the way it was, where, you know, they had it easy with you. Now they're going to come towards you and speak, you know, communicate with you. The Page of Cups is someone that is very childish. Now we've had two childish cards here. It's someone that doesn't know how to, it's like they're not emotionally mature. They don't know how to speak. They don't know how to communicate. And the thing with the Page of Cups is that they can offer you empty promises as well. It's like they'll give you all these promises, but look here, you've got a heart here that's cut out. You've got a stomach here that's cut out. So it's all just empty promises. And then you've got the tentacles here as well. It's like they're trying to draw you in, you know, with their tentacles. So they'll give you this spiel here about how, you know, they may be sorry, they'll never do it again, blah, blah, blah. But usually with the Page of Cups, it's empty. It's, they're not fully mature enough. And I do feel like when you maybe try to pull them up about what's happened, they're not going to handle it very well, because they're going to handle it in an immature way. Then you've got the Ten of Cups here. The Ten of Cups is, you know, two people that were in a long-term commitment. So you could have been with this person for a very long time. You could have had children with them. You could have had a home with them. But they're realizing now that they're happily ever after, their security, the love, you know, that warmth was with you. You are the Ten of Pentacles. You are the Ten of Cups. You are the Queen of Pentacles, you know. And this is where it said at the beginning that there's going to be huge regret here. The problem is they're going to want a new beginning with you. Now, the Fool in Reverse is someone that is usually unprepared, and they're naive, that they don't think things through before they act. So, you know, there's going to be huge regret here, because it's someone taking a leap of faith but going in blindly and not looking at the bigger picture. So for some of you, it could be that you may be blinded by this person because you love them so much, you know, and fall in reverse is not getting your new beginning with this person. There is going to be no new fresh start. It's basically just going to be the same, because we've had the Knight of Wands as well. And it also, for some of you as well, it could be that you're just going to totally reject this person, that they're not going to get their new beginning with you. You know, for some of you, could be just done with them. So I'm going to get some advice for you guys before I close out the reading. What advice would you give to the collective spirit, please? What advice would you give to the collective? And don't forget the Queen of Pentacles, even though she came out, she can, you know, the energy, so you can be male as well, guys. I forgot to mention that at the beginning. So what advice would you give to the collective spirit? So you've got the World. You've got the Page of Wands. And you've got the Three of Wands. So the spirit's advice to you is, it's over, it's finished. This cycle is done with. You know, you can, for some of you, you can maybe start a new cycle with this person if that's what you want, but usually the World means that, you know, it's you're done. It's, you've closed the chapter and you're moving on into happier times. Page of Wands is something, you're going to feel really passionate about something here, and it's something you've been waiting for, something that you've been waiting to happen. And I think what it is the satisfaction that they're going to come and ask for you back, so you can say, I know it sounds kind of cruel, but for some of you, you know, this could be that where you would say to them, no, I don't want you back, just to get that closure, just to put an end to it, you know, close that door, the World's there. You know, this is all your ships sailing in, this is something, you know, that you've been waiting for. And also, I do believe, because I see this as turning your back on someone as well, and I do believe that when you hear from this person, pages are messages. You're going to get satisfaction of turning your back on them and walking away. But that's for some of you. Yeah, look, we've got the Eight of Wands as well. The Eight of Wands is swift communication, something that's coming towards you pretty quickly. Messages, you know, it could be text messages, phone calls. So yeah, this person's going to be reaching out soon to you to communicate with you. Just be careful. Spirit wants you to use your intuition when it comes to this person. You know, you guys are very highly, you guys are psychic, you're empathic, you've got great intuition when it comes to things like this, but Spirit wants you to really pay attention to that intuition. But I do believe that you knew this was going to come, you knew they were going to regret it, you know, like I said, some of you are psychic. So I think you knew that this was going to happen to you, that this was going to be the outcome. So I'm going to leave it there, guys, and you take care, and I'll see you soon. Bye.